So I want to talk about container pipeline. We heard a lot about it in the last couple of hours, and it's an interesting problem. Let's start with the good old days. In the good old days, you had a build server. You put everything on it. You put all your deploy tools, all your libraries, all your code, and you ran it, and everything worked fine. Until one day, a developer comes and says, I need a new version of this tool. I need a new version of this library. But you still need to keep the old ones around for other customers, other hotfixes, other developers. So you get a problem. And now you start with the easy way. The easy way is very easy. You simply get another machine, put a code on it, and continue on. Your only problem is separate what gets to build to run where. And everything is great until another developer comes, and another one, and another one, and another one. And suddenly, it's not as easy as it was before. Much harder. And for that, today, we don't have this problem because we have containers, and we can use them. It's very easy to use them because they are separated, as people said. It's easier because now we have containers that can allow us to separate everything, separate the libraries, separate the tools. Let's talk about a very simple pipeline. We all know what is a simple pipeline. Having to get the code, having to build the code, having to run tests, having to package it and eventually deploy. We all know how to do it. And the easiest way to do it with containers is basically separating each step or each tool into its own container. And it's great, we have a pipeline built out of containers, and an example would be much, much better here. So let's take a very simple example. Let's say we have a service. Service made out of nodes that is using tests with Mocha, and eventually get deployed to Azure. Now, node doesn't have a real compile stage, but it would still be fine. So we all know the commands, and we can separate each one of them into its own container, and it would be great. Those are the commands that we usually use, npm install, run test, build, eventually zip the results and push them to somewhere. So I use a very, very simple Docker file to do it. It's based on Node, and it has some tricks inside that will be clear in a moment. Because while containers are great for this separation, and they're very, very easy, they still have some problems, some minor problems, when you move away from the world of a single machine or a complete machine to the world of containers. The first problem is secrets, and it would be available in a moment. The problem with secrets is that, well, you can't bake them in. If in the past you could keep them on the machine and know only you have access to the machine, it is no longer correct. You need to load them, and you can't load them initially. So you load them during runtime. The two ways that I know of loading secrets during runtime is using environment variable or using files. Both are a bit of a problem as they are still exposed inside your container. The other problem is state. When we had a single machine or multiple machines, we could share state between the stages, between our tools. We can take tool A, could take the output of tool B, etc. When each one runs in its own container, usually we don't have them. We start from scratch each time. The way most systems handle it is using mounts. Now, mounts is great until you have multiple systems, multiple computers running your containers. The last problem that I encountered is permissions. You usually don't want to run your containers using root. You want to run them using a user. When you run them in Jenkins, like I saw before, you actually need to use the Jenkins user on your local machine, on your local slave, and you bake it in. There are no other solutions. So to summarize, I really, really like using a container for the pipeline. I really, really like it because it's much, much easier, make my life easier, make the developer life easier. Still some unsolved problem, but we'll find it eventually. So my name is Eran Zimbler, and I work for BNY Mellon, which is the most enterprise with a capital E company that can be. And well, that's everything. Thanks.